on Chico. It's the first Assembly of God's Singing Christmas Tree. Join us now to help celebrate the Singing Christmas Tree's 25th anniversary. Brought to you by Austin's Home Furnishings and the Newton Bracewell Chico Funeral Home and Mausoleum. And now, here's your host for this evening, Bruce Lang.
Welcome, everyone. The 25th anniversary of Chico's very unique Singing Christmas Tree. We'll be here for an hour for the next hour. Special broadcast live right here on Channel 12. We are live, and we are very chilly, so if you come down to Arbutus Avenue here in Chico, make sure to wear your warm clothes. Joining me once again this year is Pastor Gene Turner, who's, of course, with the church here and also very much involved with the Singing Christmas Tree. How does it feel this year as opposed to last year where we were sitting here about the same time?
Last year there were a lot of nerves that were going on because of being the first year back. But this year is an exciting year with the 25th anniversary of the Outdoor Singing Christmas Tree. The celebration that we've had planned for the weekend with the originators of the tree, the Anita and Vernon Klemin, mm-hmm. and also...
Who we'll be talking to a little bit later.
We'll talk to them later, and the Elrods, who were pastors that followed them and helped promote the tree to its height. So we're excited. We want to invite everybody to come and join us and to just enjoy a great, great Merry Christmas season.
What's it mean to you, Pastor, this tree? It's a lot more than just Christmas carols, I would imagine, isn't it?
It's bringing Christmas back to the home. Mm-hmm. It's bringing Christmas back into families the way it was many years ago. Just enjoying a good old-fashioned Christmas and realizing what Christmas is all about. It's more than just the tinsel and the lights and the commercialism that we see mm-hmm. in so many places today.
Well, it has been quite a success story. 1961 was the first year for the Singing Christmas Tree.
That's correct. And there was a period of time where it wasn't put on, and then last year we brought it back for the first time. Mm-hmm. And this year we're celebrating the 25th time that the tree has been presented here in Chico.
Okay. Good crowd. You can say hello. You're on television now, everybody. There we go. You should come by the First Assembly of God Church once again. It is a little bit chilly, so bring those warm gloves and hats and enjoy an hour of very good music. We'll be here again also, not live on Channel 12, but Sunday and Monday night concerts too.
That's
right?
That's correct.
Okay.
Rain or shine, we will be here.
Okay.
Come and enjoy the tree once again.
Okay. We will be back very, very shortly with the 25th anniversary of the Singing Christmas Tree. We're going to take a few commercial breaks, but we'll be back with our concert for tonight. So please stay tuned with us.
The Singing Christmas Tree, brought to you by Austin's Home Furnishings and Newton Bracewell Chico Funeral Home and Mausoleum.
This Christmas, you'll find thousands of great gift ideas at Austin's Home Furnishings. Choose from a fabulous array of unique gifts of art and beautiful home accessories. There's something for everyone on your list, and a gift from Austin's will be treasured for generations to come. Gift certificates and layaway are available, or use your Austin's charge. All of us at Austin's would like to wish you the happiest of holidays. Austin's Home Furnishings in Chico, getting better all the time.
Hello, I'm Rick Newton.
And I'm Bob Bracewell from Newton Bracewell Chico Funeral Home.
Having been born and raised in Chico, both of us now enjoy spending time with our own families. At Newton Bracewell Chico Funeral Home, our years of funeral experience mean a lifetime commitment to you and your family in your time of need.
Only the name is new. The tradition of caring continues. Remember, Newton Bracewell Chico Funeral Home and Mausoleum.
Brought to you by Newton Bracewell Chico Funeral Home and Mausoleum and Austin's Home Furnishings.
Right away, are we all ready to go, everybody? Okay, here's the 1992 version of Chico's Singing Christmas.
Sing joy, believers, Christmas Day. Sing joy, believers, Christmas Day. Sing joy, joy, joy. Come on. Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
100 people have joined us out here to watch the singing Christmas tree. Once again, we are at the First Assembly of God Church. We're going to take some breaks right now and be back in just a few minutes, so stay tuned.
The Singing Christmas Tree, brought to you by Austin's Home Furnishings and Newton Bracewell Chico Funeral Home and Mausoleum.
First Assembly of God Church on Arbutus Avenue here in Chico. We're going to take a few commercial breaks and come back with more of Chico's outdoor singing Christmas tree. So stay tuned.
The Singing Christmas Tree, brought to you by Austin's Home Furnishings and Newton Bracewell Chico Funeral Home and Mausoleum. The Singing Christmas Tree, brought to you by Newton Bracewell Chico Funeral Home and Mausoleum and Austin's Home Furnishings.
Welcome back to the Singing Christmas Tree here at the First Assembly of God Church. It's my pleasure to be joined right now by Anita Klemin, who is the tree originator. And Anita, as we sing with the choir in the background, tell us a little bit about how you got this idea. What, 31 years ago?
Well, I was concerned about getting the Christmas story out to my city and community. Uh-huh. And when I got the idea of a singing Christmas tree, and I could see in my mind's eye a beautiful tree with 100 voices, uh-huh, angelic voice singing, and to get the Christmas story out to my city and community, uh-huh, rather than keeping it within the four walls and confines of my church.
Where did you ever get the idea for a scaffolding like this that is actually a singing Christmas tree? Had you seen it somewhere else?
No, I had not seen it. I'd done research and I looked everywhere, and it just came into my mind. I could see it in my mind's eye with these 100 voice choir. But I knew I'd have to find someone that could interpret my dream on a scaffolding, on wood. And so when we came to Chico to pastor the church here, we went out to Abner Anderson. Mm-hmm. I shared my dream with him, and he just in a few days or a few weeks came up with a scale model of a tree. It was exactly what I wanted.
It must be quite a bit different now, 31 years later. Huh?
It's fantastic. Mm-hmm. It's just fantastic.
And you live up in Oregon now.
We live in Salem, Oregon.
Uh-huh. And mm-hmm, down for the holidays, obviously.
Yes, right. Okay. A special invitation to be the guest here at the Singing Christmas Tree.
Well, you more than
deserve
it.
This is marvelous.
Well, thank you very much for joining us.
You're sure welcome. My pleasure.
We will return, as they are singing behind us, to, once again, the 1992 version of the Singing Christmas Tree. So enjoy.
The Singing Christmas Tree, brought to you by Newton Bracewell, Chico Funeral Home and Mausoleum, and Austin's Home Furnishings.
Welcome back once again, everyone. I'm joined right now by George Elrod, who is the former pastor of the First Assembly of God Church. And, George, you were pastor between 1964 and 71, it was, wasn't it?
1964 to 71. We were here for seven Christmas seasons.
So you were here when the Singing Christmas Tree was a fledgling idea between Abner and Anita and a few other people, huh?
That's right. It was still in its infancy.
What did you think of it when you first heard the idea and when it first came to fruition here in Chico?
I thought it was the greatest event that I'd ever heard of as a minister.
Really?
To identify a church with the community.
And you were, he was sitting here with us during the nativity scene, and now the nativity scene used to be done at a different facility in town here.
That's right. It was down a few blocks here at Grace Brethren. They did the live nativity scene, and we did the singing tree, and so when we announced them, we'd say, come by, see the tree, go a few blocks to the Grace Brethren Church, see the living nativity scene.
You probably went to several towns and said you were from the particular church, and they probably didn't know that church until you said what?
Yes, we used to, we'd send out visitation teams to various communities like Hamilton City, and our people would go up, knock on the door, identify themselves, say, we're from the First Assembly of God Church, and they'd say, where?
Yeah.
The Church of the Singing Tree. Oh, yes, they knew the Church of the Singing Tree.
Well, this has come quite a ways since 1964 to 71, hasn't it?
Oh, this is beautiful, this new structure under with steel.
Uh-huh.
I was always a little apprehensive in those days.
I can imagine.
About, the safety of the people.
Uh-huh.
But this is beautiful. Putting it all together like this, they've done a good job.
The Singing Christmas Tree has become famous worldwide, hasn't it?
Worldwide. We began this with Abner Anderson, our construction man. We began to let it be known that we would supply plans how to put it on, the whole thing, at cost.
Mm-hmm.
And it went worldwide. It literally went worldwide.
Well, it makes a great television spectacle, too, that's for sure. George, what are you doing now? You living down south a little ways there?
I live in Modesto. I'm not there often. I'm an itinerant preacher. I'm supposed to be retired.
Mm-hmm.
But I agree with my good brother Billy Graham when he said, never heard of a preacher retiring. So I do travel now for the Assemblies of God.
Okay. Well, it's a pleasure having you here, and we're very glad that you came up today to this rather chilly night to honor the Singing Christmas Tree, which is in its second incarnation in,
yes.
Once again.
And I'm happy to see it reborn.
Okay. Well, thanks for being with us.
Thank you, sir.
We are going to continue now with the final leg of the 1992 version of the Singing Christmas Tree, so enjoy.
Stop.
The Singing Christmas Tree was brought to you by Austin's Home Furnishings at Newton Bracewell Chico Funeral Home and Mausoleum.